What's up, guys? How's it going? And welcome to the Minute Channel. Today we're going to be talking about another Persona 6 video, kind of a discussion. Again, this one is going to be about some pretty interesting stuff here that some of you may or may not have thought about. And it's just kind of a thought that I had in the back of my head for a while now. And this is pertaining to Persona 6 and kind of what's going on with the series. So if you are a fan or you've been a fan of the series for some time, you know that this series has gone through a lot of changes over the years. In fact, some major changes that have really almost rebooted the entire franchise a few times. You can clearly tell that if you have played the first game or you have played the third game or the fifth game, you can tell how different each game is from each other. Now, that is not bad. That's not a bad thing whatsoever. I think it's very well executed and it does some pretty interesting stuff, right? But today we're gonna go ahead and talk about this game series and kind of just talk about what we can expect for the rest of the series as we move forward with Persona and as we move forward with more content from the rest of the series. Now, if you are new, please consider liking and subscribing as we are moving on to 4,000 subscribers. So let's go ahead and jump right into the video here. So first of all, one of the things that I actually really enjoy about Persona 3, for example, is how different it is from Persona 1 and 2. Not to say that Persona 1 and 2 are not good games, because they are really, really good games and I really enjoy them, but I do actually kind of welcome the change from game to game. Every game has its own flavor. It has its own way of doing things. Like if you play Persona 3 and Persona 4, they are very similar to each other. But then you play Persona 5, and it does certainly some things a little bit different. However, the major shift in tone and style and gameplay is really Persona 2 and Persona 3. When you play one and the other one, you can tell there's a significant change. Now, the reason why it changed so much, and I'm sure some of you guys have been watching this my video for a long time, know, is because they have switched directors. So originally, the director for Persona 1 and 2 was a different guy, and of course he moved on to the other projects and other stuff and everything like that, and he's doing his own thing and everything, and different writers, different people and everything like that. On the other hand, we had a new guy that just kind of came in and started working on the new game, and you know, with new things, with new director, with new people on the system, in just kind of come in and everything, you're bound to get something which is basically, you're bound to get new blood, you're bound to get new ideas, you're bound to get new everything. And that's really what happens here. Is it really, it ends up becoming some sort of, I don't want to say, well, yeah, reboot, really. It does go into a different phase. It does change into something different. Now, this is not entirely bad. I don't see it as a bad thing. Although I've seen some people think that it is a bad thing, I personally don't think it is. I think every series over time can get stale, especially if they get the same thing over and over again. And I do welcome the changes from game to game, because again, it does keep the series fresh and entertaining and exciting. We need things to talk about and we need the things to discuss and everything like that. So personally, I really do welcome the changes. I think that again, they're very welcome myself. That's what I think. However, one thing that it does beg to first, how different is the next Persona game is gonna be? How different is Persona 6 gonna be with your brand new director? Is the Persona 6 director gonna do something different? Or is it gonna change this formula somehow? Is it gonna be an open world hack and slash RPG with some other crazy mechanics or something like that? You know, I'm just exaggerating here, but really, in reality, we don't know what the next director and what the next team of writers, the next group of new fresh blood, as Atlus actually put it, is going to be doing things. You know, how are they going to approach the series? How are they going to approach and obviously, Sega and Atlus purposely do this because, one, sure, there is a popularity on the series. This is the booming of Persona. You know, like if you've seen a series ever blow up, this is really the time where Persona and Shin Megami Tensei and pretty much Atlus in general has just really blown up, you know. So it's really interesting from a perspective of a fan, kind of see how this has been turning out and everything. I personally am very excited to see what they can do with the series. I think some of the stuff is very interesting, but also very scary. I think for a lot of fans, seeing a brand new director and seeing a brand new team kind of go over things can be scary, can be a little nerve-wracking. Like, what is going to happen with my favorite series of all time? You know, how are they going to handle things? Are they going to do it justice or not? Are they going to do a good job or not? And that's something that I feel like everybody who is a fan, who hasn't, you know, who's been a fan for a while, I don't think that you will be necessarily worried. But new people, new fans that are just starting with maybe Persona 5 or something like that, maybe they're like, oh man, I just want Persona 6 to be just like Persona 5, you know? I've seen a lot of people say that, and I don't necessarily think it's a bad thing or anything like that. But I do think we have to start considering the notion that being a big director with a new team and everything, and how Atlus just has more resources, a bigger team, a bigger budget. The backup from Sega is definitely going to be bigger now. I mean, Sega's just seeing a Persona. They're like going, yeah, this series is literally printing money. So they're probably going to dump some more work into it. They're probably going to dump some pretty interesting stuff. And although not bad, I definitely want to see what they can come up with, because I, again, value creativity, and I value when people want to get out of the comfort zone. They want to try something new and everything. And whether it's going to be good or bad, it's definitely gonna be different from what I've seen so far. So let me know in the comments down below, what do you think about all this? Do you think it's gonna be very different? Do you think it's gonna be about the same vein of things and situations? I see some people just thinking, again, hoping that it's just gonna be the same as Persona 5 or anything, but I think it's just boring. You know, I don't want to play another Persona 5 2 or something like that. I really just want to get a new experience. And I think having new people in the team, you don't want them to copy what other people do. You don't want to copy Hashino, you don't want to copy anybody else. You really just want to have the new team work on it and let them do their own job and see what they're gonna do. So personally, I think I'm being very excited to see what they can come up with. I don't think anything's gonna be out of the ordinary or anything like that, but I'm willing to try to see what they can come up with. Anyway, that is pretty much into this video here. Please again, like, subscribe, and everything else, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.